Did he get it done?
He created a sense of crisis and urgency along the way. He also created a lot of business for the fact-check machines. The president says a wall will stop the drugs, the heroin, the fentanyl, the other opioids. Most of the drugs, his own government says, come in through legal points of entry, where there's commerce, where there's crossing. A wall will not block the legal points of entry. The president said again, the New Mexico Free Trade Agreement will indirectly pay for the wall. It's not how it works. Money created trade deficits, trade surplus, doesn't go into the United States Treasury for free spending on other programs. The president also said, this is powerful, when he talks about these heinous, unacceptable, reprehensible crimes, murders, assaults committed by people illegally in this country. No question, they're heinous and reprehensible. But the statistics show you that the crime rate among immigrants is actually lower than the crime rate among non-immigrants. So that's cherry-picking and seizing and trying to create an emotional response. He also talked about the economic impact. They're taking jobs from especially African-Americans and Latinos. A lot of American corporations would tell you right now, they can't find workers. They're desperate for workers, in part because of a strong economy this president should be claiming credit for. So on the one hand, he's kind of biting into his own success to make this point.
What came out to you? You're looking in the right and wrong category.
Well, you don't need me. You have John King. I thought I did a great job there. But there were a couple others. You know, he said, at the Democrats' request, we will make this a steel barrier. This was not a Democratic request. This is something that Trump has claimed will satisfy Democrats. You know, it's not going to be concrete. It's going to be steel. Nobody asked for this. Democrats' problem is not the material. It's the project. He also implicitly referred again to the Obama's house. Didn't name them, but said powerful, you know,
people who build walls and gates outside their homes. Why do they do it?
Yes, the Obamas, of course, still have significant Secret Service protection. They do have some fencing, as their neighbors do. They do not have a giant wall around their house or compound, as Trump calls it. He also referred to children being brought over the border by nefarious people who are, you know, supposedly smuggling them in. He has never presented any good data for how common that is. The data we've seen suggests that is uncommon, that most of the cases are legitimate families legitimately seeking asylum.
The idea of having kids faked and recycled and taken by coyotes, as he says. You're laying that out in context for people. How significant is that?
Yeah, the numbers I've seen suggest that it's minimal. It's less than 1% of the family units that are encountered.
The overwhelming majority are actual family units.
Yes, or at least not determined immediately to be fraudulent.
1 in 3 women are sexually assaulted some way on the journey.
I don't know about that stat. I can't weigh in.
In terms of what was new, what was different, we did see him try to grow the argument. This is humanitarian. Did he go far enough?
That's a question where the Democrats would support much of the money. The Democrats don't want the beds. They don't want the big camps. They think that's inhumane. But could the president have a conversation with Democrats about more border security money? Absolutely.